Welcome to Taste Buds. I'm Terry Baez. I'm a food critic on the Central Coast.
Each week, I share my dining experiences with a partner who I call my taste bud.
Now I'm sharing my rarest epicurean delights with you. My culinary tourism has taken me to some wonderful restaurants, both big and small. Join us while my buds and I taste the world. Taste Buds will feature my dining treasures as food and wine experts test my palate, give me their opinions, and open their kitchen.
Comfort food is our first pleasure, representing the memory and flavors of our youth. When we revisit the sensory effect, it's more than taste buds in fullness. It's literally a remembrance of mother, Nana, our childhood, our life. When we become adults and let our palate expand, we try new tastes that are inventive and exciting. A restaurant with an imagination to combine comfort food and nouveau cuisine is miraculous and rare. But we have one now in Grover Beach called the SpoonTrade.
Welcome to Taste Buds. We are in Grover Beach at the SpoonTrade, a new culinary find that I consider one of the finest restaurants in all the Central Coast. Their food will comfort your soul and take you to culinary heights like you've never experienced. Come on in and join me.
Greg!
Hey, Terry.
I see you've met my friend Jo. She's my taste bud today.
Yeah, Jo. Glad to have you.
Jo has a show. She's a foodie, too. Her show is called On the Road with Jo, and so she's joining us here. This is her first time.
Lovely.
At the wonderful SpoonTrade.
Amazing. This menu, I cannot wait.
So tell us about this amazing bar that you have.
Lots of California producers, of course. We try to stick with America, at least, as a greater whole. So when it comes to beer, you'll see things from Maine all the way to California. And when it comes to wine, definitely stayed true to local producers as well as California producers. This is kind of new to the wine world. We picked these cans up kind of as a way to have an option for beachgoers.
Yeah, because you're literally a block from the beach here.
Yeah, literally a block from the beach, from the entrance to Pismo State Beach.
So we can come in here, get our can of wine, a can of beer for the boys, fried chicken to go, and take it out to the beach.
Oh, yeah.
And what is the perfect dish to take out there?
I think fried chicken, because it's good hot, it's good cold.
Yeah.
It's got a little kimchi, nice waffle to kind of...
There you go.
Finish up.
Where could we get some fried chicken? Patrick!
Hi. We have our fried chicken and sourdough waffle, the house made kimchi, spiced honey, and fried rosemary.
Mmm.
So
oh my goodness.
This is our family.
As a foodie, my teeth are my most important tools. Santa Barbara Family Dentistry keeps my mouth in pristine condition. They are friendly, effective, and always explaining in detail each step of the dental process. I trust only them with my dazzling smile.
We invite you to be part of our family. At Santa Barbara Family Dentistry, we take care of your entire family's dental needs.
Hi, I'm Jess. Welcome to Rosa's Bar. Fresh lemon. I'm going to show you how we make our most popular cocktail. Simple syrup. The raspberry lemon drop. Add some ice. It's an absolute raspberry. Bring the glass of sugar. And a float of Chambord. Top it with the raspberry.
Hi, I'm Sue Ellen at Abbey Home Loans. Are you in a reverse mortgage where one of the spouses had to come off title in order for you to get your reverse mortgage? With today's new reverse mortgage rules, a spouse under 62 is able to remain on title and never forced to leave their home.
Sue Ellen helped my parents with her vast financial expertise.
Is it time for you to refinance your reverse mortgage to make sure both spouses are on title and secure in the home that you have? Call me. I'm Sue Ellen at Abbey Home Loans, and I would love to talk to you.
The
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, I'm from the South.
Just keep
I'm
talking.
I grew up on fried chicken, so.
Wait, have you you haven't had this yet?
I haven't had it yet.
It's okay. A religious experience.
Okay. How about some napkins?
Yeah. No, we're supposed to take this to go.
What the heck?
I know.
That sweetness and the
rosemary.
Again, with the twang, with the kimchi.
I know.
So pretty much you're bringing old school food with old school drink right here in Grover Beach, yeah?
Yeah, I love it.
I do too. I love it so much. So I'm going to go back in the kitchen and watch Jacob make all of his wonderfulness for us to try. It's an open kitchen, so anybody can watch him all the time. It's pretty fabulous to watch. So I'll see you at the table.
Thanks.
In the kitchen, Jacob's domain, his place, his magical place where all the magic happens, right?
That's right.
Yeah, and we love this open kitchen. Mm-hmm. As you dine here, you get to watch him create. Nobody yells at each other like you see on TV.
No, we're very civilized and well organized, yes.
Because your cooks love to cook.
Yes, they do.
Yeah,
yes.
And that's awesome. So what are you making for us first?
Well, our first course today is going to be a raw vegetable salad, basically just highlighting multiple farms from the farmer's market that we went to on Wednesday.
You do that twice a week, go and get fresh vegetables?
Well, I go on Wednesday with my wife, Brooke, and then she kind of goes to a few other markets throughout the week for me while I'm here working.
Well, she has all the good ideas because she's the artist and I'm the craftsman, so I execute.
It's a good marriage.
Yes, no.
Use whatever is fresh and in season.
Yeah, whatever's on the stand. We reserve the right to change things up and have fun doing it. So we print our menu as often as we need to, every day, once a week, twice a month, just depending on what goes in, what comes out, and what we get bored with serving. White wine vinaigrette, Dijon mustard, white wine vinegar, and some olive oil. Very simple in here. We're going to use some Maytag blue cheese. Some toasted walnuts, because blue cheese, walnuts, and apples, I heard those go pretty good
they
together.
They do. It's a magic combination.
Some really thinly shaved fennel. Yeah, and the aroma just starts pouring right out of there. And it's important that everything's nice and thin.
What are these kind of beets?
Candy canes, chiogas, I believe they just go by multiple names. I like to get it together in the bowl and write kind of how I like it. And then we'll lift it. A little bit of blue cheese. Without the blue cheese, the salad is not the same. You get a lot of crunch and a lot of rawness from the vegetable. There's bitterness and sourness and a lot of texture, but this is gonna add the richness that you're looking for. You just kind of just let it happen. But that's it. So that's our first course today.
Oh, I can't
it's
wait
a
to
raw
try
vegetable
that.
Salad. So this is our house-made sourdough bread. We use the day-old bread for things like grilled bread, grilled cheese sandwich and stuff. It's very, very soft on the first day. It's super delicious, but I think it holds up a little better the second day for things like that.
Oh, okay.
But we do bake our little loaves fresh every day, the ones that we serve. But we're gonna let these cool on a rack, and then we bake them for about 7 or 8 minutes right before we serve them. Our other loaves are large loaves, but those are very specific and special as well. Tri-tip tartare, homemade sourdough, freshly ground tri-tip, shallots, parsley, olive oil, sherry vinegar, and some salt. Sounds like a lot of ingredients, but again, it's all about balance, I think, and texture. I always start with...
I tried this the very first night on your soft opening and I was blown away.
Yeah, awesome. And it's evolved a little bit since then, but not too much. Mostly just in presentation and balance of everything. But so you can see a really bright, vibrant, fresh, certified Angus beef tri-tip. These are freshly chopped shallots. Then we give it a good douse of olive oil richness. So we have some savory shallot, kind of onion flavor. We have some herbaceousness, richness from the olive oil, and then a little bit of acidity, I put a good amount of vinegar in there, believe it or not. We had vitello tonnato, shaved raw veal, tonnato sauce, and some breadsticks. Super plain, but super simple and extremely delicious. It's incredible. It's, one of our best dishes. If I was gonna eat here, I would eat this. Say this dish would be incomplete without some very deliciously grilled bread. So that's probably my favorite dish on the menu.
I think it's mine too.
So, spaghetti that we made here this morning.
You're making the spaghetti here?
Yeah, we had a couple pictures of that too, so that was cool. So, just some double zero flour, egg yolks, treated in a very specific way, rolled out and cut with a cutter. And then we drop that in boiling water first. We're gonna start this dish with a little bit of chicken stock. Mary, I think rosemary is very specific for certain things. It's such a strong flavor.
Right.
We have these big chunks of duck confit. So we cook duck confit in duck fat. We cook it at 79.5 degrees Celsius for 12 hours. So it's roughly 175 degrees Fahrenheit. Very specific temperature for a very, very long period of time. Becomes very tender, very moist, very delicate. Edit here. We have duck fat, we have chicken stock, rosemary, duck confit in the pan, and our fresh spaghetti that comes right out. A little bit of that pasta water is always nice. Adds a little bit of body to the sauce as well as being salted.
Okay.
So hot noodles, hot pasta is always a very important thing. So that means putting something on a hot plate is also very important.
You know, I never thought of that
cold
with carbonara.
Cold food, cold plates, hot food, hot plate. Fresh parsley. And now this is the kind of the magic part, I think, of making carbonara. And that is adding some pureed egg. So we have whole eggs here that are just pureed, strained out so there's no shell. So now we have what I believe to be kind of like a custard base. Okay? And then we'll put
the
pasta.
Oh, the smell of that. Oh.
Right here. And then we have our house-made sourdough breadcrumbs.
I love this addition to the carbonara.
And it's just about texture, right?
Right.
So we just add a pile of that on top.
Plus, I think it helps keep some of the heat in.
Yeah. So you can see this steak now is cooked medium rare. And it's basically cooked medium rare from edge to edge. We're just going to give it a good little taste of salt. And this is a pepper crusted steak too. This is a Kennebec potato, I think, which is the best frying potato out there. I think it has to do with sugar content and all that stuff. So it gets crispy before it gets brown. So this is some of the serviettes we use in the restaurant, just inspired by a handkerchief that my mom wore. So I carry it with me all the time.
That's
so
awesome.
We use them in the restaurant, and we bought hundreds of them, and we have hundreds and hundreds of them.
But that's a special one.
Yeah, that's my special one, but it's just to kind of have a little bit of her in the restaurant.
Awesome.
Very,
ooh,
so
there
hot
you
potato,
go.
Chopped rosemary, and if you smell it,
or now, steal one.
Now, to me, it's a very specific flavor from my childhood, and it's called Fruit Loops.
What?
So to me, it smells like Fruit Loops. The lemon oil and the rosemary together, it has a...
You're right.
So
these are the healthiest Fruit Loops anybody's ever had.
They're also deep fried potatoes. We have our grilled broccoli, which I don't know if we need both pieces, but I think that looks nice.
Yeah, people should eat more broccoli.
People should eat more broccoli, especially this broccoli. I slice it for one is I like to know what it looks like before it goes out because I'm not exactly sure if that's cooked or not. You know, I know that I can get it kind of a guess just right. But for one, I'm going to know that I sent out a perfectly cooked steak to you.
Right.
And if it wasn't perfectly cooked, I sliced it. I knew it. I'm not going to send it out.
Right.
So that's a very important step to me is knowing that the steak is perfect.
Famous fried chicken.
Yeah.
Chicken and waffles.
Famous fried chicken and waffles. So the first step is getting the flour onto the chicken first and put it in the fryer.
And what kind of oil?
We use a sunflower oil and we just put a couple scoops.
I'm like trying to pay attention so I can steal some of this stuff. It'll never work.
And we just use this home waffle maker. We've used multiple types and this one works the best. It beeps when it's done, and you take it out, and you serve it. Pretty
awesome.
Nice.
So why kimchi with the southern
Well, a lot of chicken and waffle houses with hot chicken will serve it with a pickle, white bread, stuff like that. So we actually decided that kimchi would be a great pickle to serve with it.
Okay.
So we just cut it up, a couple little pieces, stack it up over here, like so. And we will stack this up specifically. So then we take honey that we have heated up with garlic and rosemary and thyme and some arbol chilies. Completely cover that in spiced honey, we call it. And then we will sprinkle it with deep fried rosemary.
This is my favorite. We've got a beautiful bottle of wine here at Groundwork from Paso Robles. Patrick!
Hello!
Hello!
So here we have our shaved raw vegetable salad. We have shaved fennel, carrots, Chioga beets, pink lady apples, tossed in a white wine vinaigrette, topped off with blue cheese and walnuts and a little fennel frond.
All right, so dig in, girlfriend.
All right.
So it's raw vegetables. There's a beet, there's fennel bulb, and then there's the blue cheese and the walnuts. And he puts it all with a little vinaigrette that he makes. I know. It's not raw. And when people think that that if it's raw, it's not going to be as good. This is delicious.
If you've ever tried to purchase a business, then you know how important it is to get complete and accurate information. A certified business broker ensures that you get all the facts.
We're really thankful that we had Gary Baez negotiating with landlords and paperwork, and we could really tell that Gary had both our best interests and the best interests of the buyer in mind.
Using Prestige will make the decision process less stressful and more secure. Call us today and get all the facts.
The annual Central Coast Writers Contest has begun. Win accolades and cash with this year's theme, The Final Word. Submit your words in these categories: flash fiction, screenplay, short fiction, or poetry. Prizes up to $1,000 for the winner. Visit CentralCoastWritersContest.com for submission guidelines, to read about the amazing judges, and more.
This is our pepper-crusted New York steak. It's poached in duck fat, rolled in fresh cracked pepper, and then grilled to medium rare. We serve it with crispy Kennebec potatoes that are tossed in an agrumado lemon oil, as well as some rosemary, and then grilled broccoli. And then to finish off the dish, little bordelaise.
Here.
Yummy, right?
Pour that right there.
This is delicious. Take shots.
I think that we've invested a lot of time personally and just studying what we do. As a career, you know, we've dedicated our lives to it, and I think people that dedicate their lives to something are a very special breed of people.
Ew, I eat here way more than I should.
That's right, because there's a patio here.
There is a patio. There, I've got a table right out there with my name on it.
All right,
so the way that we can support them is for you to either come down here and try all of this, which I double dog dare you all to do. If you haven't had tartare, this is a place to start. This is the one chef that you can trust with raw ingredients to put anything in your mouth, and that's the best thing I've ever put in my mouth. So when you come in here, make sure you say you saw it on Taste Buds. So tell us about this, chef.
This is a brown sugar pot au creme, which is basically just pudding. We use a
fancy pudding from France.
Fancy pudding. It is brown sugar, butter, egg yolks, cream, and milk. Cooked in a water bath, so it sets up really nicely. So yeah, pudding, but made with a really special organic dark brown sugar, which really gives it its next level of flavor, I think.
So typically, pot au creme is usually chocolate, right?
I guess maybe for some people, pot au creme can be any flavor you want it to be, I guess. It just depends on who's making it. We make some creme fraiche in-house. We make our own whipped cream, or we whip it, and we put a little sea salt on top of it. A little bit of acidity from the sour cream in with the pot au creme.
I know.
And then served with a brown butter cookie. Very simple cookie. Brown butter, flour, baking powder. There's no egg or milk in there, so it's very crumbly. A really good counterpoint, I think, to that pudding.
The Spoon Trade is now open for Sunday brunch. Start your day of rest with comfort food like strawberry and cream waffles, blueberry pancakes, and brown sugar French toast. Or go exotic with duck confit tamales or innovative eggs benedict, all made with the love and care the Spoon Trade is famous for. Start with a red beer, Bloody Mary, or fancy bubbles, and finish with hot, fresh coffee cake. There's always room for the famous fried chicken and waffles. Sunday is the fun day at the Spoon Trade. So next part of Taste Buds is I'm taking you out to be my taste bud. Awesome. We're gonna go to a wonderful little taco stand called Frutiland. Yeah, the flavors there and the things that Jose are doing are really phenomenal. Another spectacular meal at the Spoon Trade. This is my happy place. This is, I think, one of the best restaurants that has been introduced to the Central Coast in a very long time. And you all must put on your adventurous eating jackets and try it.
You know what makes a nightclub legendary? For beginners, it's the atmosphere. The drink selection, the bands, and don't forget the dancing. You know where I'm talking about. The only place where you can catch live entertainment 7 days a week. Harry's Nightclub and Beach Bar in Pismo Beach. Under new ownership, and yes, now taking credit cards, Harry's Nightclub is a must-stop in downtown Pismo Beach. So come on out and create your own memories at Harry's Nightclub and Beach Bar.
This is our family.
Great service, good work. It's pain-free and everything's fast and all is on time.
With the treatment, my gums are perfectly fine now and there's no problems at all.
That they make you feel comfortable, they take the time to explain, and they take care of you. We invite you to be part of our family. At Santa Barbara Family Dentistry, we take care of your entire family's dental needs.
Located in a large, bright yellow box posing as a taco stand in Aurora Grande is Frutiland La Casa del Sabor, or the House of Flavor. It is one of those rare culinary happenings where an entire family is making sure that you are satisfied with their fresh, amazing Mexican food. Hello, welcome to Taste Buds. Today we're at Frutiland.
La Casa del Sabor.
I didn't get it right, so he's going to do it. And this is chef and owner, Jose Rojas, and we are joined by executive chef Jacob Town of the Spoon Trade. We're very excited to try some Mexico City delights, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So what are you going to make for us today?
We're going to make the tamale, fish tacos, steak tacos, fruit cocktail, piña colada, and the beer.
And clams, because I love the clams. My clams. They are my favorite. Have you had the clams here yet?
I have not.
Oh, they're so good. They're better than all the fancy restaurants. So come join us. We're in a little house of yellow wonderfulness in the middle of Aurora Grande.
And you make these tortillas?
Yep.
They're awesome. They look
amazing.
Look
at how thick they are.
Yeah,
the fish has already been seasoned with...
Marinated, yes.
With onions, garlic, cilantro, what
oil.
Else?
Oil.
Oil.
You notice another restaurant, they give you two tortillas.
Mm-hmm. Right.
There's no way. You can have just one, and then a good size, you don't have to with any food.
It doesn't fall apart.
Yeah.
Yeah, it holds together.
Yeah, you get awesome. It.
One of the other things I like best here is the Hawaiian taco.
The pineapple.
Yeah, it's with the grilled pineapple and carnitas, right? So you're deep frying the tamale. That's
yep.
different.
That's a good idea. Yep. I might have to take that back with me.
Those clams.
So this is a family-run place, right? Your wife is in charge?
Yes.
Yes.
My wife's in charge, too.
She's the owner.
She's the owner?
Yeah.
She writes you a check once a week if you're good?
She's the owner of my heart.
Yeah. Aww. Oh, that's how he's making the cheesy bread. That bread is so good.
Just a lot of thought behind it all.
Yeah, let's make the cheese.
A lot of thought.
We'll make the bread for you, Mary.
So tell us about your family. Who else works here?
It works my sister, my mother-in-law, my nephew. Very much all about family over here. Mm-hmm. keep the same secrets.
The same secrets. The chef can't help himself.
We're real close over here.
Don't
worry about those.
Sisters. I love
gotta,
that he just helped himself.
You gotta let him cook. You gotta let him like that. I'll explain you why.
He said, don't touch it.
Don't touch my wire.
You know what I mean? What is this?
Touch.
You don't see this. You don't see any of this anywhere else.
I know.
Presentation, combinations.
Fish tacos. There's three.
This is the half order.
Yeah. The food here is huge. And even though it's kind of a taco shack, you give us cloth napkins.
Always, yeah.
I just love that. I love that.
Well, I definitely cannot wait to dig into this. Food looks amazingly unique, and I've never seen anything like it before.
Oh, speaking of unique, this is the only place on Grand Avenue you can get a real pina colada. So one of the other things they have that's really wonderful here is a children's menu. It's one of the healthiest places to get your grandkids a meal. This is one of the healthiest takeout foods you can get anywhere. So what I do is drive by, get it, take it home, and pretend like I made it.
With tacos.
The fish tacos. Uh-huh. I get the El Pastor with the grilled pineapple tacos.
Same tortillas.
And they're sweet and hot and spicy and the same as here, but this was a milder with a little bit of the mango and the tropicalness of it was what I loved best.
Not only do you don't see this anywhere, it's very unique, but it's very thoughtful also, like with the special thickness on the tortillas, the crispy fried tamale, the dried pasilla versus a fresh pasilla.
Like, I know.
There's little details that get thrown into everything, and it's really, really good. So what is pico de gallo?
Pico de gallo, you're asking me. You know what pico de gallo is. It's fresh fruit with chili, lemon, lime, salt, and I think a little bit of tamarind, right?
Awesome, yeah. No, it's a great condiment to go along with everything, you know, to balance out the heat, nice crunch, sweet, it's cool.
That's a cucumber. Mm-hmm. See you next time on Taste Buds, and make sure that you live well and eat well.
There's a little cornstarch, baking powder in there.
Specific a little what?
Baking powder.
Cornstarch.
No. I don't know what that would be.
It's corn.
Your mind
starch.
Is going elsewhere.
I know.
You're sweating for a reason you're not sure why. I think my favorite part of the day is when my hands are completely coated in bread dough, burger bun dough, or even batter from a chicken and waffles. I would walk around with batter-coated hands all day long if I could.
So glad to be here. So glad to be had. This is my potato. If anybody eats it, I'm gonna kill him.
Yeah.
This is my
microphone.
Can you see there's a little piece of chicken?
There's chicken.
I just want to make sure. I want to roll back and make sure.
Thank you for joining us. That was delicious. Please make sure you complete the social media challenge and give me your feedback. Join us next time and see where my palate will lead you. And remember, eat well and live well. We'll be right back.